I find it exciting when companies create solutions that could decrease the use of toxic chemicals. This not only saves honeybees and restores beekeeping to its proper place, but also benefits our environment and ultimately us, human beings. Previously, I made a video about a new device designed to save honeybees from the parasitic mite Varroa destructor. The results on paper were amazing, beating even the treatment protocols used by experienced commercial beekeepers in Israel. But would the American beekeepers reach similar results? Early this year, the Israeli company ToBe visited the United States and let a commercial beekeeper play with the device the way he wants. Well, it wasn't any beekeeping operation. They visit Wonderful Bees, one of the largest beekeeping operations in the United States. I spoke to Mr. Steve Richmond, head of the beekeeping department at Wonderful Bees, and find out what happened with the device in his hands. ToBe developed a device that can deliver precise amounts of any substance into the honeybee hive, and got the attention of many beekeepers worldwide, myself included. The ability to fight Varroa mite infestation at the same time lower the amount of chemicals used is something that is really important to me. It works like this: you choose the treatment you want, synthetic or natural, put inside the device, position the device in the entrance of the hive, press the button, and done. The device will take care of the Varroa treatment throughout the year, delivering precise amount of the treatment many times a day, several days a week, without the need for the beekeeper. The test was organized as follows. ToBe team, together with Wonderful Farms, set up colonies in two groups in two different honeybee yards. One group, the control group, received the standard Ametrax strips, commonly used by beekeepers, while the experimental group used the new device. On days 1 and 2, they measured the initial colony strength and load the Varroa infestation using standard procedures. After 15 days, they evaluate the colonies again. They found that the standard Ametrax treatment was only 30.5% effective, reducing the infestation from 4.6% to 3.2% in yard number 1. However, the big surprise from Mr. Richmond from Wonderful Farms was the 95% efficacy of the new device, which reduced the Varroa load from 4.5% to 0.2%. What about the second honeybee yard, which had even more Varroa than the first one? Well, the device performed even better, with an efficacy of 97.6%, reducing the mite loads from 7.9% to just 0.3%, while the control groups that use the standard Ametrax treatment has an efficacy of only 64.7%. If you ask me, I believe the results might be realistic. I truly think the way Ametrax is used with a device with gas pulses might be much more powerful than the strips to kill mites. But what happened with the mites inside the brood cells? Would them be affected by the new device treatment? Well, I knew Steve would not let that question pass without an answer. 16 days after the start of the treatment, they pulled brood frames and open brood cells and count mites, and what a surprise. On the yard number 1, the controls using strips showed around 7% infestation levels, while the group using the device only had 0.9% infestation. Similar results happened with the yard number 2. Controls, 8.9% infestation, and the group using the device, only 1.8%. It is encouraging to see tests taking place with American beekeepers, and I'm hopeful that this device might offer a real help to beekeepers in the near future. But what I like it the most, as you probably know if you watch this channel, is the significant reduction in pesticides use in this case. I'm not a big fan of the way pesticides are used today, and believe we have an obligation to find ways to reduce their use, not only for the sake of the bees and pollinators, but every life on Earth, including ours. This device is a step in the right direction in my view, and when you compare the whole amount of pesticides used in the two groups, you can clearly see the difference. In the control group, each hive received a total of 1 gram of Ametrax, while the experimental group using the device used only 0.2 grams of Ametrax, precisely released at the right time and quantity. This represents an 80% reduction in pesticides use. I wish you could see similar reduction of neonicotinoids in corn seeds in the future. I like to dream about those things sometimes. It is important to note that while the device currently uses Ametrax, other protocols such as oxalic acid might be incorporated in the future. Oxalic acid is less harmful and can be very effective when used correctly. I'm looking forward to see a protocol that uses non-synthetic pesticides methods with this device. So what do you think? Do you see this device as a good idea or not? Should we ask the ToBe team to send me 100 devices for me to test independently with some of you guys at home? If you missed the other videos about the device, please watch this video right here. I would like to thank my Patreons for their support and you for watching Inside the Hive.tv, the show about beasts. See you guys next week.